Bom dia! Hello, Portuguese learners! How are you today? Tudo bem? I'm Carolinti, and in this episode, I would like to do with you grammar. I want you to broaden your knowledge about verb to be, estar, and I want you to know how to ask and answer to the question, where are you? In Portuguese! Fica comigo! Verb estar is the one of the verbs that mean to be in Portuguese. The other verb that also means to be is ser. Link to the lesson about verb ser you can find in the description box below. Verb estar belongs to irregular verbs of present tense presente do indicativo. Its conjugation presents as follows. Eu estou, tu estás, ela, ele, você está, nós estamos, elas, eles, vocês estão. Let's repeat it. Eu estou, tu estás, ela, ele, você está, nós estamos, elas, eles, vocês estão. Verb estar is used to describe states or actions that can be changed. For example, a sopa está quente. A sopa está quente. Verb estar is used to ask and answer about moods. For example, como está? Como está? Estou bem, obrigada. Estou bem, obrigada. Verb estar is used as well as an answer after picking up the phone. Instead of hello, Portuguese say often estou, or even make it shorter to sound to. Verb estar is used to ask and answer to the question, where are you?
Where are you in Portuguese is onde está? Onde está? Onde means where, está, of course, is the third singular person of verb estar to be. So all together is onde está. The first part of the answer is very easy. It starts with a simple estou em. Estou em. Estou is the first singular person of verb estar. And preposition em means in or at. All together is I am in, I am at. Estou em. Estou em. The second part of an answer, of course, depends on your location. Link to the lesson about names of different places in Portuguese you can find in the description box below. What is very important here, that definite article that stands before chosen location joins together with a preposition em. Have a look yourself.
When you want to say a sentence, I'm in the cinema, you start with simple estou em. Cinema in Portuguese is o cinema. Preposition em joins with masculine article o, which give us no. Estou no cinema. Estou no cinema. Preposition em joins with definite articles as follows. Em and feminine article a give us together na. Em and masculine article o give us together no. Em and feminine plural article as give us together nas. Em and plural masculine article os give us together nos. Em and a give us together na. Eng and o give us together nu. Eng and ash give us together nash. Eng and ush give us together nush.
Let's see another examples, shall we?
When you want to say sentence I'm at home, you start with što em. Home in Portuguese is casa. Casa doesn't have any article, so preposition stays in a basic form. Što em casa? Što em casa? When you want to say I'm in the bank, you start with što em. Bank in Portuguese is o banco. So preposition em and article o join together to nu. Što nu banco? Što nu banco? Another example is post office. I'm at the post office. Što em? Post office in Portuguese is os correios. Preposition em joins together with article os. And we have sentence što nos correios. Što nos correios.
Što em casa. Što em casa. Što no escritório. Što no escritório. Što no jardim. Što no jardim. Što na igreja. Što na igreja. Što no restaurante. Što no restaurante. E você? Onde está? That's all for today. Thank you for your attention. I hope I helped you in comprehending Portuguese grammar. Let me know in the comments below. Don't forget also to leave your thumbs up, share and subscribe. I see you soon. Até já!